now steady on the sake as Sandy Shaw, without her shoes, naturally, is among those letting their hair down at the Karaoke Club.
Have one thing in common. Her mother calls her as a failed Jap too, but she's not Japanese, she is Jewish American princess. And she makes her living in this country by grilling other people, asking about their private lives on national TV. Very strange profession. Please welcome, fresh from the success on the maternity ward, Miss Ruby Wah.
I know how to cope with these ethnic shows. Here we are. I know what to do. I've done thousands.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Ethnic something?
Sweetheart, could you just massage my back? That would be fine.
Is that American attitude? Like American attitude. That
are we going to go back through
this? We like Japanese polite attitude. Can we do that? Because this is my club. Is it all right? Okay?
Yes, it is your show.
Like me, you are so-called bloody foreigner in this country. Why did you choose to work in this country? Why aren't you in America, your home country?
Sorry, I didn't understand the word you're saying. Sorry, I'm just blinded by her teeth.
I like your teeth too.
Can you write the subtitles down there so I know what
you're
talking
about? Do you like my lipstick too? No.
Why? Is it on your teeth? No. What is the question?
Oh, sorry.
In English.
What? Like me,
yeah.
You are so-called bloody foreigner as well.
Yeah.
Why did you?
I'm not as foreign as you are. I mean, compared to you, I am the queen.
My club.
My club.
No. You're getting booed. Don't, my guest. Shut up.
It's her show.
Why did you come to England? Why aren't you working in America?
Because they wouldn't give me a job in America. And they pitied me here, so they took me under their wing.
Does your humor go down better in this country than in America?
Well, not in this particular club, but not here at all. So I'm really sticking my foot out. Yeah, I don't think they think I'm very funny in America.
Do you have any reservation about British people? Does British people irritate you?
Irritate me?
Mm.
No, I love them. I clutch them to my breast. They're fabulous people. They're fabulous, fabulous people. What, I'm lying? Okay, I'm lying. I can't stomach them. Slow? Please, slow. Let us discuss using a telephone in this country. As you hear the sound of the ocean on the other end of the receiver.
I heard, actually, you were actress once with the Royal Shakespeare Company.
Yeah, I was. I was a classical actress in this country before the adenoids kicked in. I started off in the Royal Shakespeare Company. It was totally misplaced. I snuck in there. I put my underpants on my head. I hoiked my stomach up. I made a cleavage. And I cornered the wench market. I did a lot of that and put straw in my hair. And got away with it for a while until they figured out nobody in Love's Labor's Law should be from Chicago. So then I was fired. It's true.
Right.
Am I talking too fast for you?
Weenie bit.
A weenie?
Just a weenie bit.
Okay,
yes,
slow down.
Very little bit. But I like your accent very much.
I'll
very
break
exotic
you down.
For
Is
me.
It really?
Yeah, very good.
Do I have
does
an exotic accent?
Does like British people take Mickey out of your accent?
They hate me, yeah.
Do they?
I don't think, well, they hated Americans more 12 years ago when I got here. They really, we were the target practice.
No, you accepted.
Well, I wouldn't leave, so I think they got the hint. Mm-hmm. But when I first got here, you know, people would, like, blame you for Vietnam and congratulate you on going to the moon. And I've never been to either place. I've never been there.
You've just made a film about going home to Miami, aren't you, right?
Oh, sorry, little.
Do you like Miami? Is it a nice place?
No, this film is my revenge on my country. You know, this is the dream of every Jap, you know, is to go there with a camera crew and shoot exactly why you don't want to go back. So, this is my farewell to Miami.
Right. I think we are getting sushi now. So while we are eating a sushi, maybe we can look at the clip from this documentary film, Miami Memoir.
Okay. Okay.
None, it's coming off. I'm going real delicate so that none of it falls off.
Who sees sand? What's the difference? Sand on the carpet.
Now, don't sit down. Your rope is wet.
Mom, there's plastic on the soap.
What's water's the not difference? Gonna hit the it's soap. Wet.
Oh, I'm just going to go take a shower. We have two
showers. No, you go on downstairs and take your shower there and then come upstairs. They don't even have fire.
Oh, that's a funny part.
The next time, get that sand off before you come into the building.
All right, look, I'm going to walk out now.
But no, walk out any old way you want.
No sand is going to hit the carpet.
Get rid of that
look,
sand.
Look, I'm balancing you walk the sand into perfectly on my feet.
Downstairs to
I'm
take
going downstairs to take a shower. Look, good. No sand is coming on the carpet, none.
How do you know?
No, I can see. I have microscopic vision. There's no sand on the carpet.
Oh, this is raw.
Yes, of course.
Yeah.
Oh, please. Oh, I'm sorry. Eating a fish embryo.
Does your parents like this film? What they thought of it?
Well, my parents think it's a film about why I'm insane. So they thought the crew was brought to Miami to prove their point. That something's wrong with me. But anyway.
How do you think your parents want you to be like? What they were expecting you to be like?
Probably to be producing children at 200 miles an hour also, and bring home that husband in the style that can keep me in the style I should be kept in. And it's all gone hideously wrong.
Do you think you are a bit similar to your mother? That's why
I'm turning into my mother, and that's the ultimate nightmare, because I already am starting to clean stains off of passing cars. You know what I mean? I can feel my hand making that claw shape to get at the sponge, you know, and see sort of that hair that drives you insane. So I'm turning into her gradually, mm-hmm. Yes.
Hey, Paul, yeah, you're right.
Hold on. Sorry. I'm just eating the only safe raw eggs, and I'm enjoying every moment.
I'd like to talk about your mother, because I heard your mother was a big influence on you.
She's very warm, very strong, and she's been good for me. And mm-hmm. She's taken me through some very difficult times in my early life, just as my wife has taken me through some very difficult times in my later life. So they're a good team.
Right. Enough family business from Europe. So we'd like to go into the karaoke time. So what are you going to sing a song? Which song?
I'm going to sing As Time Goes By from Casablanca. But hold on. But I need an Ingrid Bergman type figure.
Right. Because this honorable MP from Brent South is so shy, we provide perfect Japanese version of Ingrid Bergman. So you are going to sing with our beautiful geisha, Kamura.
You must remember this. A kiss is still a kiss. A sigh is just a sigh. The fundamental things apply. As time goes by, and when two lovers woo, they'd still say I love you. On that you can rely. No matter what the future brings, as time. In love,
never out of date.
Hearts full of passion, jealousy and hate.
Woman needs man,
and man must have his mate.
That no one can deny.
It's still the same old story. Up you get.
For
fight for love and glory. A case of do or die. The world will always welcome lovers as time goes by.